Hi everyone, welcome to the next video of this lesson, guys, of this day, where you need to be understand about how we can set up the event and what is that event is. So far we already installed our base pixel code. Facebook now can communicate with your website and start tracking the whole data, and Facebook will have the old data from your website. They already been linked now. Now in this video I will be show you what is event. Now what, guys, you need to be understand that part. Sometime people come on your website, they took some specific action. For example, what specific action? They call you, they contact you, they put your product into the add to cart, they download something from your website which you already offer on the website, they book a free consultation if you offer a free consultation on your website. It depends on the business to business, but taking a specific action, taking a valuable action on your website, that we called as an event. We can track those people through that events, right? That we called as an event. We need to be set up that events onto the website. Basically that means is, if your website, you want to be track some specific action that is valuable for you, that is you want your customers should take it, you can track those actions we called as an event setups and or events, right? If you're on the screen, you will be see it here. Events are the valuable action people take on your websites, like download ebook, whatever your business offers. Some business offer download books, some business offer free consultations, some business offer free catalogs, some business offer free webinars, some business offer free contact, any kind of things you want to track, that tracking we called as an event tracking. Why it's important? You need to be captured that events, because later on I highly recommend to set up some events, set up some points onto the website. Then later on you know that you need to be know that what kind of people, what action they took on it from our website, and you can retarget those people accordingly, right? For example, I'm going to give you an example. If some people contact, some people download your sheet, it means some people come on your website, Facebook have their data, that's fine, but some people do not download your sheet which you offer, but some people download your sheet. If the people download your sheet, it means that they are most interested in our services, so we can target those people accordingly, right? If you're on the screen, guys, basically you have to understand that people are taking an action on your website. For example, add to cart, as the people come on your website, they put the product onto the add to cart, that's what it is. You can track those people who put your product into add to cart. Now there is a two way to set up an event. There is a two way we can set up events onto the website. We can put some points, we call it as an events. We can set up events onto the website. There is a two way. First way, it's standard events, that's offered by Facebook, and I highly recommend that part. They have some special category I will be show you in a minute. They have some specific categories, which categories you are looking for, and you can set up standard events that provided by the Facebook. And the second is custom conversion event, guys. Some custom conversion events, some websites, sometimes Facebook are unable to give you a category that you are looking for. For the another way, Facebook give you an option that you can set up a custom conversion event. If Facebook says I'm not able to cover your category points, if I'm unable to cover that you're looking for, you can create a custom based on your requirement, right? That's also awesome, guys, but I highly recommend go for the standard. In the next video I will be show you how you can actually set up the old custom conversion or standard conversion that will be help you out. But for this you need to be understand what is event is. Basically you can track the specific action on your website, and we called it through that events, and we called as an event setup that part, right? So in the next video, I will be showing you how you can actually set up that events. People who comes on your website, they purchase, they put your product, add to cart, or whatever the specific action they took it, so that it will help you in future to finalize our ROI, to how much we spend, how much we earn, everything. We will be see through it here. I hope that will be help you out, guys. In the next video, I will be show you how you can actually set up the standard events or the custom conversion event. Thank you so much, guys. See you in the next video.